In our last topic, we have studied two lines, the transversal and angles made by transversal, and also we have studied some important properties. Now, in this topic, we will learn the properties of parallel lines. First, we will study the interior angle theorem. Now, interior angle theorem. We will prove this theorem. Now, the statement of theorem is, if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, the interior angles on either side of the transversal are supplementary. If two parallel lines are intersected by transversal, then the interior angles on either side on the transversal are supplementary. That means angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree, and angle C plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. That means these pairs are supplementary angles. We have to prove this. Now, given things here, line L parallel line M. Line L parallel line M. And line M is their transversal. Line M is transversal. And as shown in the figure, angle A, angle B are interior angles formed on one side. Angle A and angle B are interior angles formed on one side. And angle C and angle D, angle C and angle D are interior angles formed on other side of the transversal. Now here we have to prove that angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree and angle D plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Now, here we have to prove that angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Angle A plus angle B. These are the interior angles on one side. And angle C plus angle D is equal to 180. This is the another pair of interior angles on other side. That means all the pairs are supplementary. So in the proof, I will see proof here. Three possibilities arise regarding the sum of measures of A and B. So here, three possibilities arise here. The first possibility is there, angle A plus angle B is less than 180 degrees. That means sum of angle A and B is less than 180 degrees. The second possibility is sum of angle A and angle B is greater than 180 degrees. And the third possibility is sum of angle A and angle B is equal to 180 degrees. Now, we will consider all three properties, possibilities, one by one. Now let us assume that possibility 1, that means angle A plus angle B is less than 180 degree, is true. So if we assume the first possibility is true, that means angle A plus angle B, this sum is less than 180 degrees. And if it is true, then according to the Euclid's postulate, if these two lines, line L and line M, these are produced, then these lines will produce, will intercept each other on the side of transversal where angle A and angle B are formed. Now angle A and angle B are formed on this side, okay, on the right hand side. And if we produce these two lines on the right hand side, then these lines will intersect each other. If this is true, then these lines will intersect each other. But we are given that line L and line M are parallel. It is given. So if these lines are parallel, then these lines will not intersect. And therefore, this first possibility, angle A plus angle B less than 180 degree, is impossible. If these lines will not, if these are parallel, the parallel lines never intersect each other. Therefore, these two angles, the sum of these two angles will not be equal to or will not be less than 180 degrees. So here our first possibility, assumption of first possibility is impossible. Now we will consider the second possibility. Now let us suppose that angle A plus angle B is greater than 180. This is true. Now here angle A plus angle B is greater than 180 degrees. If this is true, now we will go step by step. Now see here, angle A plus angle B is 180 degrees. And angle C plus angle D is equal to 180 degrees. These are angles in linear pair. So both the angles are angles in linear pair. Now this is correct statement. See, angle A and D, these are angles in linear pair. So their sum is 180 degrees. Angle C plus B, these two angles are in linear pair. Their sum is 180 degrees. So angles in linear pair. Now see here, if we add these two statements, after adding these two statements, A plus B plus B plus C, angle A plus angle D plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degrees plus 180 degrees is equal to 360 degrees. And therefore angle C plus angle D, and take these two terms, angle A and angle B, to the right. So here we get angle C plus angle D is equal to 360 minus angle A minus angle B. That is equal to 360 minus into bracket angle A plus B. Now if angle A plus angle B is greater than 180 degrees, according to this possibility, if angle A plus angle B is greater than 180 degrees, then this subtraction will be less than 180 degrees. Because if this sum of angle and angle B is, if this sum is greater than 180 degrees, then the subtraction will be less than 180 degrees. And therefore, angle C plus angle D is less than 180 degrees. That means this angle, this sum will be 180, less than 180 degrees, according to this statement. And if according to this statement, in this case, line L and line M will intersect each other on the same side. If these lines will produce, they will intersect on the same side of the transversal here C and D are false. That means if these two lines will intersect on this side of the transversal, that this sum will be less than 180 degrees, will not be greater than 180 degrees. Angle C plus angle D is less than 180 degrees is impossible. This sum will not be equal to less than 180 degrees. And that is, angle A plus angle B is greater than 180 degrees is impossible. Okay, now here second possibility is also impossible. Now we go to the third possibility. Now we have seen that first possibility is not true, second possibility is also not true, first two possibilities are impossible. That means the third possibility is true. And that possibility is A plus angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree is true. That means angle A plus angle B is 180 degree. And similarly, angle C plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. That means this pair is supplementary and this pair is also supplementary. So here, note that in this proof, because of the contradictions, we have denied the possibilities A plus angle A plus angle B is greater than 0, sorry, angle A plus angle B is greater than 180 degree, and angle A plus angle B is less than 180 degree. These two possibilities are denied because these are not possible. Therefore, this proof is an example of indirect proof.